I got involved in this sport to open up everybody's eyes. And even in the sport of boxing, this is a fucking dirty business. This is a dirty business. And I'm involved in the sport along with Leonard Ellerbe and Steven Espinosa. I communicate with them and Al him so we can clean up this sport. It's about cleaning up this sport. Should Canelo, right now, he's not my fight, but should Canelo be fighting Chavez? Absolutely. Absolutely. But it's so crazy. When we talk about loyalty in the sport of boxing, when we talk about loyalty, when you look at Canelo and Steven Espinosa and the Showtime team, let this, and myself, we helped build this guy up. He was fighting on my undercard. He was the co-main. We helped build this guy up. And you know what Oscar De La Hoya do? You know what Mr. Loyal Oscar De La Hoya do? I'm sorry, Miss Disloyal Oscar De La Hoya do? He take him right over to HBO and cut a deal with HBO. And when he cut the deal, he got money, but I bet Canelo didn't see none. But this is, these are the things that people don't know about in the sport of boxing. Because Al Heyman was a smart, shrewd businessman. They want to sue him because he was smart. You know, all people leave, we work smarter, not harder. And I'm gonna make sure he just became world champion. I'm gonna protect my champion. And when I'm ready for him to go out there and it's worth it, if it's not worth it, we're not gonna do it. It has to be worth it. We gonna fight some bouts. There's no rush. He's still a kid. Just like myself. And so I'm gonna stand behind my fighters. And I love my fighters more than the sport. Because I care about the well-being of a fighter. Because I was a fighter my fucking self. I was a fighter myself, and I was on their side. When you, like I said, what I touched on earlier is what nobody understand about the things that we go through, the fighters. When you got a family member, you know, you got people that say they really care about your well-being, right? They really care about your well-being. You know, I didn't know nothing about Nielsen ratings. A lot of things I didn't know. You know, when I didn't know nothing about contracts at all, or nothing. I was a teenage kid. They took me to a company, and they know what they're doing. They know exactly what they fucking doing. What they do is they put a check, a six-figure check right there, and a contract, and the whole time, they already know what you're gonna do. If you a kid that come from poverty, and you don't come from nothing, when you see the 100,000, to you, that's 100 million. So I'm looking at their check like, okay, I don't care about it. Where do I sign that? But who took me in that office without telling me, you need to take this to a lawyer? No different. We don't hold fighters in a chokehold. But if I feel like we invest, I feel like we at least should get our investment back. We should at least break even. Who the fuck wanna lose when they invested? Not me. So what you gotta say, L, you wanna go over and talk to the people? Well, let me introduce the new IBF champion of the world. Because the only thing I do, I speak from the heart. I don't care if you don't like it, because, you know, y'all gonna go home and live y'all life the way y'all wanna live y'all life, and I'm gonna go home and live my life the way I wanna live my life. And like I said before, when it's all said and done, I know who genuinely love me, who care about me. You know, the thing is this, every time, like at the end of the day, he was a showman tonight. But I'm gonna let him come up here, he gonna talk, but, and it was boring, he was a showman. That's what the game is about. It's about give and take. It's not really about taking the money, but it's about giving the people what they want to see. This is a business. It's about entertainment. And when we talk about entertainment, we knew tonight was going to be a good night. And tonight wasn't a good night, it was a great night of boxing. And that's what Mayweather Promotions are here to give you, a great night of boxing. So I'm letting my champion come up here and talk. We're still glad Badu's champion. We really supposed to have both of the belts, but we're still going to give him a bonus. We're going to give my young champion right here a bonus, too, because that's what we do over here. We appreciate our fighters. We love our fighters. Gervonta Tank Davis, the new IBF 130-pound world champion.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
I just want to thank, you know, my team, you know, my hometown for coming out, you know, my promotion, you know, Floyd Mayweather, Lenny, my management, you know, Al Heyman, and just believing in me, you know, there was a lot of people going against us, saying that I lack in experience, you know, and I showed tonight. I'm a dog, you know, and I will continue to be a dog. And, you know, I'm going to continue to listen to my team. You know, we're going to take over boxing. Thank y'all. Yeah.
I know y'all got questions for him, so let me let the questions
Gervonta, Chris Connor here from Last Call. We spoke to you last week, and you laid it out. You said you're going to take him out to deep water and drown him. Were you surprised that he basically played into your hands, that he wanted to stand and bang, give up his jab and try to knock you out early on?
I think he was trying to press me out, you know, to see can I go into deep water. And, you know, we showed him what sharks do.
All right.
Mr. Davis, congratulations. Floyd, congratulations to you guys, too. Fair. Question, amazing fight, exciting crowd. You stepped on the ropes and
you
realized that you're not. Tell us what were you feeling? What was the feeling?
You know, like I said, I have anger in me that only, you know, get the show when, you know, when I'm in the ring. You know, I can't use it outside the ring. You know, the emotion in me, you know, I show no emotion in training camp leading up to this fight. You know, that was just, I didn't cry, you know, just winning that world champion, you know. And my team just believing in me, you know, me getting the job done.
Gervonta, congratulations on your fight. Thank you. Andy Rosario, the weekend. Were you surprised that he lasted as long as he did, given the number of power shots you hit him with throughout the fight?
He's a champion, you know, a tough champion, so I knew he would last. It's
like, how you doing? It's going to be important for BrooklynFights.com. First of all, I want to say congratulations to you.
Thank you.
For being with us, as well as the coach.
Say Showtime, too.
Excuse me, pardon me, Showtime. My beverage. You know, you've been through a lot. Like we talked before, Baltimore has been lost since I've been. How does it feel that you, you know, bring the belt back to Baltimore? Matter of fact, it was nothing.
You know,
champion,
let me kind of touch on that. I know you, everybody don't know how the boxing game works. So, I'm the one that's going to enlighten you all on how the fight works. I mean, how the boxing game works. When you become world champion, when you win the belt, right? When the champion has the belt, in the ring, they give the belt, you know, to the guy who wins the belt. Like, we give the belt to Tank inside the ring. He yells it up for everybody. He walked back into the dressing room with the belt. And then he has to return the belt. He has to return the belt to his opponent. And then, because you keep your belt forever. It's like a trophy, you keep that forever. And then within weeks, they'll send you a belt. And then you'll have a belt forever. So that's how it works in a fight game. Come on back, Texas, we talk to the people. Y'all, I'm always talking. Go ahead.
How does it feel, you know, bring the belt back and bring us one back to Baltimore?
It felt great, you know, been through what we've been through, you know, just, again, my team, you know, showing that hard work pays off, you know, showing that, you know, we accomplish goals, you know. And again, a lot of people went against us. And, you know, I believe in my, you know, my management, my promoter, my coaches. You know, so we stuck to the game and we did what we did.
Darrell Johnson, New York Beacon. The man to your right was glowing up here talking about you. Was excited ringside seeing you dominate. How does that feel to make the TV proud?
It felt great. You know, once again, we grew up on Floyd Mayweather. You know, just him being there, you know, showing me the steps of the way right there. You know, I was listening to him more because he'd been in my shoes before. You know, so it felt good.
Gervonta, Petraza had some moments in the fight, particularly in the fifth round when he started to really kind of unload on you. I don't know if you were setting him up for something, but at what point in the fight did you know you had him?
I know I had him about like the fourth round. You know, when he was catching me in the fifth or sixth, I was let him, you know, beating him, and you know, and then I took advantage.
Question. First, I want to say congratulations to Leonard and Floyd. Been having cards here for a few years, and I think this one did really well. 10,000 plus. I want to ask you guys if you were happy with it. The buzz was great in the building. The Aline fight was really good. The women were good. Davis was great. The main event was really good. I just want to say congratulations. I saw you guys working hard all week. And I think it was a really great showing, and that's good for the sport because the sport needs really great showings and filling up buildings. So congratulations on the hard work, and I want to, you know, hear from Leonard and then Floyd. Maybe, you know, are you guys happy with this?
We're very happy. First off, we'd like to thank everyone for coming out. Can't say we're very, very pleased with the turnout. I'd like to give a special shout out to my team. They bust their ass out there with working, doing everything they needed to do. I'd like to thank Showtime, Barclays Center, Lou DiBella and his team. It was a wonderful, wonderful promotion. And that's what it's all about, boxing is about putting asses in the seats. And as you see, with the first card being here this year in Brooklyn, you see the turnout. We had to open up more seats tonight. We couldn't turn the crowd away. And that's a wonderful feeling as a promoter, you know. And again, that's what Mayweather Promotions is all about. You know, we're a very elite promotional team. In the past, people hadn't given us the credit, but we have arrived and we're taking over boxing. And again, I'm very, very proud of my staff and all our fighters, you know, had a great night. So I'm fortunate that Badu got the bad decision, but we're very, very proud of Tank. He went out there and did exactly what we knew he was going to do. We're very proud of Delorme and our young fighter, King Robles. It was a great night, with the exception of the bad decision in the Badu fight. But overall, you know, like I said, we're very pleased with the turnout, and that's what it's all about.
Sure, James Miguel and Badu Jack will be here soon to communicate with you guys and give you guys, you know, enlighten you on their thoughts, you know. But I know what I thought as a fighter. You know, I've been there before, so, you know, a lot of times when they say stuff about, you know, when they look back at my career, they, of course, try to say, oh, this guy did this or this guy did that. I mean, me, myself, within my career, if a guy went three rounds, they gonna say he won the fight. So they were so harsh on me. Even if he won four rounds, they gonna say he won the fight. Let me let Mr. Showtime himself speak. Steven Espinoza, a guy that gave me the biggest deal in sports history. All right, ladies and gentlemen, Steven Espinoza.
The deal worked out pretty well for us, too. You know, I want to be brief, and I want to commend the Mayweather promotion staff and the Barclays staff in particular. You know, we're hard on each other in this sport. I think we're harder on ourselves than any other sport. We're hard on the fighters, we're hard on the promoters, we're hard on the networks, and we expect a lot, and sometimes we expect too much, and we're a little too harsh. So when we get it right, I think everyone should recognize it. And this is the kind of night, you know, that makes me proud to be in this sport. Because the fighters took tough fights, the promoters did the right matchmaking, the promoters did the right marketing, and everybody who came here tonight went home happy and with great memories. And so again, I have to commend either the fighters in particular, Mayweather Promotions and the Barclays Center for putting on what is a great night of boxing, a great night for the sport. And these are the kinds of events that elevate the sport to where it should be. And together with Mayweather Promotions, you know, we'll be doing this all year on Showtime. That is our commitment to you guys.
Tell you about his fight. We just signed him, you know, to Mayweather Promotions. The only thing we want to do is get him, you know, we're moving the right way. We'll get you that title shot. We'll get you what you want. It's all about, it's a process. Nothing happens overnight. Everything is a process. We'll take our time, make the right moves, and soon he'll be back in line for a title. You know, Leonard, I want to commend Leonard and the Mayweather Promotion staff for just busting their ass and working day in and day out. Every time, you know, every time I communicate with Leonard, it's like, I'm like, where you at? We working. What y'all doing? We working. And it's a lot, you know, it's a lot working with fighters. And you would never know until you're on the other side. Once you're on the other side, you'll see it takes a lot to build a fight of this magnitude. So I can just imagine the thing they had to go to build my fight. To build my fights. Let me make sure I put an S on there, because when I say fight, I'm talking about one. So make sure I put an S on there, my fights. Leonard, like I said before, I'm proud of you. I'm proud of everybody that covered this event. Paulie Maginale, former world champion, two different weight classes. A guy that really knows the sport. And, you know, I want you guys to give Paulie Maginale a round of applause.
Paulie!
That's one of Brooklyn's finest. And one thing about him, he got hard. He's going to fight his ass off. You know, he can't take nothing away from Paulie. I mean, but I don't know if he's a better commentator than he was fighter. He's doing a hell of a job. And we need more guys like him in the sport that's commentating, that knows the sport of boxing. A lot of times we got guys out here, people out here that's commentating that don't know anything about the sport. You know, if you put in a certain position and do a job, do the job. And trainers, I want to let a lot of trainers know this. I'm not here to knock any trainer in the sport of boxing. But just because you can hold some pads, some hand pads, don't make you a trainer. You have to be able to be in a fighter head mentally, as well as just helping him physically. You have to be in his mind mentally. You have to have him right mentally before he can go out there and prepare physically to go out there and do battle. Boxing is not an easy job. Everybody now think they're a trainer. They all submit, you know, they train in a female at the fitness center and they move over to a boxing gym. Now they're such a great trainer. Holding mitts don't make you a great trainer, once again. It takes a lot more than that. You know, if you get with a guy that's already, if you build a guy from day one, then that's your protege. That's the one you started with. But once he get to a certain level, if once you get him to the championship level, and he's under my banner, if he need my help, then I'm going to help him, because I know how it is to be in that crunch moment. Never knocking any trainer. But me as a fighter, you got trainers out here that say, oh yeah, oh I got trainer of the year 8 times, I got trainer of the year 10 times. I don't care if I never get promoter of the year or trainer of the year. I did my job as a fighter. I went out there, I gave a world what they want to see. Now it's about these young fighters on the rise. It's about taking them to the next level. Now, it's not about Floyd Mayweather anymore. But if I can help them, if I can help build them and take them to the next level and surpass me and break my record, that's what I'm here to do. We're here to give back to the sport of boxing. You know, it's so crazy. When I was in the sport, when I was fighting and I had a promoter, I was seeing the numbers that I was making.
say, okay. I looked at the number that I was making. I'm like, okay, that's cool. As soon as, you know, I was going to say when I had another one, when the time was right, I was getting 7 and 8 million and the right numbers. But as soon as I left the promoter and became my own boss, we're talking about 8-figure and 9-figure paydays. Because I learned the business. You know, you have to master one thing. You have to master one craft. Then you move to the next. It's stages. You master one thing, you move to the next, and you move to the next, then you move to the next. I know about the boys and ratings. When I was young, I was like, oh, I can't wait to fight on HBO. Then you fight on HBO once, then you want an HBO contract. It steps to this. Then you become a pay-per-view attraction. Then you're trying to put asses in the seats. Then you're trying to make sure, because every time I fight, I already know my fight is going to be sold out. I'm not worried about that. I'm worried about getting better each time. Each time I'm trying to surpass that time. But what we're focused on at Mayweather Promotions, we believe in the fighter winning. If a fighter needs a fitness, if he needs a strength and conditioning coach, if that's going to help him get to the next level, then use them. I'm behind it 100%. Whatever's going to help these fighters win in the sport of boxing and get to the next level, I'm with it. I'm not here to tell you how to dictate and control your team, but I'm always going to be honest with you. Because I want to be able to go to sleep at night and say to myself, you know what? I know I was honest to that fighter. I knew I was honest to that man. And I sleep good every night because I'm honest. Always. You think me and Leonard LB, see eye to eye always? Absolutely not. When I was a lot younger, when I probably was 21 or 22, I go crazy like the same way, but growing, maturing, mentally, maturing. And as I matured, I said, you know what? Real men sit down and resolve their problems by communicating, not cussing and arguing with one another. You know, and as humans, everybody here, anybody, all of us in here can contradict ourselves. We're only human. And I want nobody to say, oh, I won't contradict myself. Yes, you would. It's like you would say, oh, if I had money, I wouldn't buy this. How you know? Get the money first, then say what you would do. You won't have that same mentality. Oh, when I get money, I'm gonna be in the hood. No, you're not. When you get money, you don't supposed to be in the hood. The goal is to move out the hood. It's called levels. You're moving up.
Right.
You know? The same people I was friends with when I was 21, now that I'm almost 40, I'm not friends with anymore. I'm a different person mentally. We don't have to say, they want to go out to the club. They want to drink alcohol. They want to hang out with bitches all day. You know, are we grown? I can say bitches. It's my plateau. Just because I use that don't make nobody better than me, because somebody said, oh, I don't use that language. I'm not a bad guy. I'm a good guy. I love my family just like y'all love y'all family. You know? Tell y'all a little bit about myself. I don't care about a five-star restaurant. That's not me. I like holding the wall. I like to eat holding the wall. I'm evolving. I'm changing. It's growth. If I know I got a driver, I know I got drivers. I'm not driving anymore. Most of the time, all I'm doing is traveling all day. I'm on a jet, I'm over here. I'm on a jet over here. I got fighters all overseas I'm dealing with. I got a boxing gym in Moscow, Russia. I got stuff everywhere. So, am I able to drive a Bugatti anymore? No. So what I said, it's time to get rid of all these cars. There's levels to this. And once you get out the car stage, now you're in the jet stage. So you know, I'm not thinking about the car anymore. Huh? No time to drive. Because when I'm in the car most of the time, I'm texting. Leonard, what's going on with this? You know, what's going on with this? Rome, I need this. And I gotta plug my gentleman's club, and some people to the world know it as a strip club. Yes, I have a strip club. And that's, we understand, a nightclub come and go. But like I said before, I'm a businessman. And all of us in here is grown. The name of my club is Girl Collection. And there's three things we know. Ass, titties, and pussy will never play out. Not saying that it's a whole house. We're not saying that. We run a legitimate, honest business, and within how many weeks, bro? 2 or 3 weeks we'll be open. And when y'all come to the fights and things, swing on.
Be open for the Santa Cruz?
Hopefully, I gotta talk to my guy. Yeah, and what we bring is something totally different. It wasn't easy, you know. In the city of Las Vegas, we all know about different gentlemen's clubs or different strip clubs. Cause some people like strip clubs. Some people like call them gentlemen's club. Okay, the thing is this about our club. Rhino is wanting all the skinny girls with the big boobs. I'm not against that, you know. But I have an open mind. But I said, you know what? There's a lot of people that want to see girls with curves. But a classy club with girls with curves. So we got all type of women at our club.
A little thickness.
kind of like that bankroll, Will. And I just want to just say thank you to everybody in here, because everybody played a major key. I thank Alex Ariza for working with DeLorme. They worked together before. Alex Ariza is back working with him. I want to see Alex working with some more fighters. He's a hell of a strength and conditioning coach. Elvis Grant, you know, a lot of people don't know who Elvis Grant is. Let me introduce Elvis Grant. I'm gonna do the talking, Elvis, but come on up. Those are his gloves that we always see. Yeah. I don't know how long he's been my buddy or my friend, but he's been my friend. He's been my friend and my buddy a long time. I see them Gucci slacks you got on. and that Rolex watch.
I learned from the best.
I just want to say I'm proud of you, Tank. You know, just sitting down with Tank. Letting him jog with me when I was preparing for a fight. Just sitting down with him, going over the game plan so many times. And I'm not gonna lie, I was worried because that guy can fight. He beat a hell of a champion tonight. And I want the city of Baltimore to really be proud of him.
Yeah.
I want the city of Baltimore to really be proud of him. But one thing we have to do, I tell him, because when you care about somebody and you love somebody, you always tell them the truth. I knew that my career would be where it is at if I stayed around my friends that didn't have the same mind frame that I had. Not telling him to leave his friends. But when you get in a position, put them in a position to change their lives for the better. Put them in a position to change their lives for the better. To teach them about positive things. You know, a lot of times we like to shine for hood. Oh, I'm gonna show out on the hood. I'm gonna show out on the hood. They jealous of you. You gotta realize, it's somebody, it's more like, okay, he hanging around Floyd Mayweather. He's with Mayweather Promotion. Yeah. I'm gonna try to do something to him. We don't want that to happen to you. We love you. We care about you. That's why, you know what? I let you do your training camp with your trainer, because he know what he's doing. He care about you. And he genuinely love you. Me and him talk hours. Me and Lauren, you know, I want to commend Lauren also for doing it. We're Lauren. Lauren, he's a man that's behind the scenes also to help a lot of fighters. I want to commend and thank you for helping so many fighters. And that's a guy that's been behind Tank, helping Tank. But his whole staff and his whole team and all his buddies that hang around him. You know, a lot of times they be looking like this. You ain't gotta look like that, my man. You know, I understand business and I understand helping this guy grow. I don't need to be around him talking, oh, Tank, you need to do this. I don't need to be around you talking to you at all. You need to go back to square one and go back to who you started with. Your trainer he's a hell of a guy and he care about you. He love you genuinely. We need more trainers like this. He'd go through every fight with Tank for free because he love him. It's just genuine love, no different from Lauren. Lauren genuinely care about, Tank, when I was over, I took Tank to Dubai to try to get his, to try to get him right mentally. I took him to Egypt, try to get his mind right. You know, I think I took him to, I don't know how many different countries I took him to. We probably went to Paris. We went so many different places. But me and Lauren sat on the phone and we talked for hours. For hours. And we need more people like this in boxing. A lot of times, a lot of these trainers only care about themselves. I'm telling you. Oh, we need them more. I need to get this. I need to get that. Come on, man. If the fighter is taking all the risk, then the fighter should get the lion's share. Look, none of y'all don't got these boxing bruises. None of y'all may not, he may wake up in the morning pissed him with love. You don't know what can happen. There's been times I've been in the ring, I don't talk to y'all about it. I got broken wrists, all knuckles broke, hands still messed up to this day. Body all broken up. And all the, oh, we want to see you fight again. We want to see you fight again. Why? Why? For what? Oh, you need to break Rocky Marciano? For what? I did it my way. I'm proud of Rocky Marciano. I'm proud of Ali, Joe Frazier, Joe Lewis, and every other champion. You're talking about all year, you can make this much money. You ain't going to be able to spend the money the right way if you ain't right mentally. Or invest it right if you're not right mentally. We care about our fighters over here at Mayweather Promotions. We genuinely care about the fighters. This company is here to stay. We're not going nowhere, so get used to us. We're gonna continue to build these young champions. And I, like I said before, when I step, I like to step away. I'm glad I stepped away from Tank. Okay, if it was 3 months or 2 months to let him go back to day one. Back to knowing how I feel to be in the grind. Like go back to how I feel in Baltimore when you had to keep, when you had to walk to the gym or you had to jog to the gym. Same old attitude. It wasn't easy for me. But you see what this kid did in just 16 fights. So imagine what he's gonna be able to do 10 fights later. Yeah. 10 fights later. But my goal as a father figure is to teach him about investing his money right now. So whenever he's ready to quit and hang it up, he gonna say he wasn't just one of the best fighters in the world. And he wasn't just one of the best ones in the world. He was a real friend. And that's what we need. People that genuinely care about us. I talked to Leonard. Leonard was taking so long for the fighters. And you're interested. USADA has to, you know, be with the fighters because it's all about playing in the sport of boxing. Random blood in your intestine. If I'm not mistaken, you go back and read the articles. I'm the one that started that. You know, I was a pioneer of random blood in your intestine. If I'm not mistaken, you know, I got so much backlash and I was scared and I was a coward. I said, all Floyd do is run. Yeah, you're right. Run right into the bank. I run right to the bank. So, you know, Elvis, I want to thank you. You've done a remarkable job for so many years, you know. And, you know, I know you give us everything free always. But, you know, on the next go around, I'm going to get new heavy bags made because we're changing. We're moving to a new, we're getting a new boxing gym. We're trying to get a boxing gym here in New York City. And I've been working with my team about Mayweather Fitness gyms all around the world. We're gonna get Mayweather Fitness gyms all around the world. It's all about being healthy. You know, people are dying extremely early now. And my New Year's resolution, even for myself, is to drink a lot more water and eat more healthier. Because if anybody know me, they know, you know, that's why I be on his head. I be on his head like, so all you want to do is eat fried food. You want to eat burgers. Stop. So I got to lead by an example. So if I eat healthy, you want to eat healthy too. Okay. And, you know, I know they got 24-hour fitness in L.A. Fitness, but, you know, make some room for me. You know, make some room for me. We just want to... There you go.
We got one.
Give it up for Bobby Jeff.
Yeah.
say anything? I'm gonna talk to people before I bring them up. Let me know.
I say thank you for my web promotion. Thank you, Floyd Mayweather, for the opportunity. I'm very happy for the team now. Thank you for my team, RS Lisa, and my wife who working hard with me together. Thank you, everybody.
Tomas.
You know what? That's a very, very, very good idea. But then you have a fighter that may be biased. So that works kind of like he may like a certain fighter and judge it because he's biased. So,
even with a small background, though, even if they had like an amateur career or something, guys that are looking, again, maybe these guys are looking like when they had Canelo winning a long time, but maybe they're looking at it from a different lens or something.
I don't understand what's going on. I mean, we probably need to get some younger judges. I mean, I don't know what's going on, but how I'm feeling, I don't really want to come back and really fight on the East Coast anymore. This is not right.
Boy, can't you acknowledge that was just a close one?
No. No. Fuck no. No. No.
What was the question?
No. Boy, he know he lost. He can come in here. Fighters come and do press conferences all the time, then go to the doctor.
Not in New York.
Okay.
Floyd, given the fact that the fight was so close.
Fight wasn't close.
Correct. Would you like a rematch?
No, I'm going to answer that. I'm going to answer that. It's a little different now. We run that company a little different. Me and Badu Jack, we already communicated, we talked. The goal was to fight this fight, then for him to move up to light heavyweight. Now, Badu Jack is a big, super middleweight. The thing is this now in boxing. If they can't get it right the first time, they're not going to get it right the second time. Because we don't need no second time around. Only time we needed something second time around, when they come to me and say, Mayweather, we don't think you won. You don't, you sure? Or just because the guy won three rounds, or he won four rounds, you think he won the fight? I said, you know what, line him up again. Badu Jack asked me, and I feel bad because I wasn't a man of my word. He said, Floyd, am I going to get a fair shake? I said, don't worry about that champ. Absolutely. Guess what? He fought the last fight. They tend to sweep that under the rug when he fought in D.C. The guy failed a drug test. But then they still want to put it on his record. Boxing Rec, take that shit down. Take that down.
It's
going to get changed. Going to get. It don't take no 6 or 7 months or a year to take it down. That's easy. This is bullshit. we're not gonna be like other promoters and pay judges off. We're not doing that. Treat us fair. Just treat us fair.
Robles over there, what are your thoughts on this first fight tonight?
I want to commend Elvis and his son. They've been nothing but generous. Elvis was on me tough about this young kid right here. Elvis was on me, your dad unified champion. Yeah, don't worry about it, man. We know he's the champion. I'm proud of you, champ. I'm proud of you. Are now dying with us. We got big things that's gonna happen for you. Just go out there and do your job. We're gonna do our job. In the beginning, let me tell you, don't worry about the money. The money will be there, just like my career. The money will be there. It'll come, you do what you gotta do. We'll do what we have to do.
Well, did you want to see Jack go straight?